My name is Mike, and here are this week's new and trending AI tools you certainly cannot afford to miss. Now, if you want to see how I did those really cool video effects, stick around. It's one of the tools that I'm going to feature in the video. But first of all, I got this delivered this week. It's a Rabbit R1. And then just as I was showing it off on a live stream on the channel, someone said, be careful of the security breach. So let's find out, what's the deal with the Rabbit R1 security breach?
Rabbit R1 security breach. Hard-coded API keys exposed, allowing access to user data and potential device manipulation.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah, my opinion of it so far, it's a great toy, but actually, I've given it to my 9-year-old because he asks a lot of questions, and now he has AI in the palm of his hand to help answer them. Most of the questions are about Mr. Beast, by the way. Anyway, let's move on to something a little lighter, and we'll look at Figma. Figma had an amazing event this week. Now, you may remember the name Figma because Adobe wanted to buy them for $20 billion, but the deal was abandoned because, well, regulatory roadblocks. So Figma had an AI event called Config 2024 in San Francisco. And the best thing to come out of it? Well, I think Figma Slides, or maybe they'll be known as Flides in the future. 3.5 million people created presentations on Figma last year. But now with Figma Slides, they've solved a lot of pains, such as speaker note integration, collaboration, design consistency, and even audience engagement with this really cool live polls feature. I think that's going to be great when I'm building talks in the future. I'm going to use a Figma Slide live poll. That's super cool. Let's hop in and take a look at it. So here's my option to sign up for a free starter account and get started. So I'm going to present with Figma Slides. This is brand new this week, and I think it's really cool, not just for me to work, but also co-create with others. So let's get started with Figma Slides. Now, obviously, it gives me a bunch of really cool templates. This may replace, certainly, PowerPoint. And hey, who knows? Even Keynote from Apple may be in line. So let's go for this template. I think this looks really cool. And it gives me a lot of different ones to start with. So let's create from this. So we'll start off by calling this AI Tools This Week. I'll also go in and edit Mike Russell and the date today, which is, of course, the 28th of June, 2024. Here is my first presentation slide. So I'll create a new slide here, and let's do another one, and let's type into this top bit, Figma, and then over here we might put captions, and I see that's rolling over, but no worries. I can just drag that out a bit until it fits in, and then if I want to go ahead and put more text in, I can go ahead and do that down here. So I'll go ahead and write in here, ElevenLabs, and of course I can go for headline one just as the other one, and then we'll go ahead and move this around to fit. Now, if I want, I can, of course, rotate it like that. Now, if I want to mix things up, I can go ahead and change the colors of my slides just like that. Just one click can give me a really cool, funky looking style. Now, I've got a bunch of tools at the bottom, such as inserting more text, images and videos, shapes. I can insert tables, live interaction, which is what they were showing in the keynote. This is really cool. So I can actually say, you know, do you agree or disagree with something? Also, with the plus button, I've got access to different icons. So if I want to go ahead and insert a nice beaker icon, I can do that, resize it and make it look really good. Hold down the shift key to keep the size in proportion. And that is a really cool starting point. So there you go, a load of new features baked in. This is a beta product right now, so go and try it. It's free for the rest of the year. As a content creator that gives a lot of talks on stages, this is going to be so handy. It's going to save me time. It thinks for me, and I can share and collaborate with others rather than having to download the whole presentation, upload it to Google Drive or wherever, share it, and then download it again, edit it, and re-upload it. So whole load of time-saving features baked into Figma Slides or Flides. Go and try it for yourself. If you're enjoying what you see so far, like, subscribe. I do these roundups every week so you can get the latest AI tools that'll work for you. Next up today, I'm going mobile twice actually. First with the Captions app. This is what I use to create that funky introduction you saw at the start of the video. So as you can see here, here are my AI edits. Now to create an AI edit is really easy in the app, and you can select a style, watch as AI edits your video, boom, from start to finish with custom graphics, B-roll, transitions, zooms, all added instantly. And then it's going to give you amazing results like these. My name is Mike, and I'm trying the new AI edit feature in the Captions app. It's an amazing new video AI tool that allows editing to be seamless. Hello, my name is Mike, and I'm trying the new AI edit feature in the Captions app. It's an amazing new video AI tool that allows editing to be seamless. So let's see how well this cuts my video and adds mind-blowing transitions to really make this video pop. So there you go, AI edits. It's going to be great if you film a lot of vertical video shorts that you want edited quickly. I really think this is production ready. You can throw stuff into this and get pretty decent results from it. Captions is a pretty epic app that's backed by investors such as A16Z, and I recommend you go and try it out. Sticking with mobile, let's look at the new app from ElevenLabs. Now, we know that ElevenLabs make great AI voices, but they've now got a reader app here that you can sign into with your ElevenLabs account and have pretty much any content read aloud to you. Let's try it out. Voices presently in English, but multilingual coming soon. And here we can see we've got some examples here and a little help prompt to get started. But let's actually go in and click the plus icon and add some content for ElevenLabs to read aloud to me. Now, as you may know, I do these roundups weekly to find the best AI tools. Here's the back catalog, and you can actually go to this link, which I'll have down below, to go and sign up for my newsletter so you never miss another update. Here is my recent update. I'm going to copy the URL to this and paste it into my iPhone. Okay, using the magic of Apple's clipboard, I can actually go in and paste this link and then just click listen.
Hello, fellow content creators. This week's roundup is packed with AI tools that you'll have to see to believe.
Okay, so that was narrated by one of ElevenLabs' own voices called Alice. But if I like, I can actually head into the app and change and select my own voice, which I've cloned with ElevenLabs. So let's try that.
Hello, fellow content creators. This week's roundup is packed with AI tools that you'll have to see to believe. Brace yourselves.
Okay, I'm going to stop that cloned mic there because he actually reads and narrates aloud better than I do. So there you go, you get the idea. Now, obviously, you can change the speed of narration, which is pretty good if you like to listen to things on double speed. You can also go up into the top right and select to share or save. This is apparently a feature that's coming soon, so it's not enabled just yet, but very soon you'll be able to do that with all your ElevenLabs narrations. And it's really neat if you're an audio first learner like I am and you can't stand to read things, you prefer to hear them said to you, this app is definitely for you. You can go and download it for free right now in the iOS App Store, and it should be coming soon to Android as well. And some bonus news in brief, Adobe updated Premiere Pro earlier this month. 24.5 is the version. Well, let him explain it to you. Adobe Enhanced Speech got a little update in version 24.5, recently released of Adobe Premiere Pro, normalization now included, and more vocal improvement techniques. Ah, clarity with enhanced speech improvements. Lovely. Also, Claude 3.5 Sonnet is now my daily driver for AI. I absolutely love the new model out of Anthropic. I suggest you go and try it too for your content creation tasks. And finally, Riverside have constantly been releasing new updates. Well, I tried their new HD live streaming studio and it really is good. You can connect multiple accounts like YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, TikTok, and then go live with ease. No technical jargon or any worries like that. And then afterwards, you can get the show notes, the chapters to add to your video and even promote it using magic clips, which create nice vertical shorts to put on YouTube shorts and TikTok, for instance. Anyway, go and watch the video that's showing on your screen now. It's on my other channel where you can dive deep into Riverside's new live streaming features. You'll also find it linked down below. Enjoy.